Well, I research in a number of areas. I'm a professor of physics and also in the medical school for molecular cellular physiology. I work on batteries. I work on electrochemistry to split water, to reduce carbon dioxide for energy products. I work on things like recovering lithium from seawater with novel electrochemistry. But I also work on nanotechnology synthesis for medical probes, biological probes, for both very basic research, but also for biomedicine. In terms of glucose economy, I don't know how I got stuck with that label. That's only a very, very small part of what is going on. Today, for example, I spoke about that you can have a partial hydrogen economy because with inexpensive electricity made from solar and wind and electrochemistry, you can produce hydrogen and oxygen and you can reduce carbon dioxide for energy products. And this is why being an electrochemist today is so exciting. Well, in terms of the sustainable goals, a very crucial part of these goals of the UN are public health, clean energy, clean water, improved agriculture, productivity. All these things are tied together. And many of the things, if you had abundant, clean energy, you could have a lot of these things. You could have irrigation, you could have clean water, you could have higher agricultural productivity, and you can produce energy where you no longer pollute the air and have these huge hazards. So all these things become one part of this problem, and this is all the issues of clean energy, enough food, clean water, clean air are actually intimately linked. Well, the university has many roles. Number one, it is a place for intellectual discourse where it can help the students and help inform society of what are the challenges that we face today. And not only what are the challenges, but actually how can we meet those challenges and prevail. The issues of climate change, the issues of public health are very serious issues, just as disease and medical advances. All these things, most of the discoveries have come out of universities. And so this has been true in the past, it will continue to be true in the future, that it's the universities that do lots of the scientific research, lots of the beginning engineering research. But most importantly, it's in universities where you have these discussions about how one could best benefit society. And so universities will continue to play a very important role in how humankind moves forward.